What's going on, all of my healthcare professionals? I hope that you are having a wonderful day. We're continuing on the ACLS Megacode scenarios, and today we're going to be looking at stable tachycardia. Let's get started. So beginning with our patient scenario, we have a woman who is recovering in the PACU after an elective surgery. She reports feeling well, her blood pressure remains unchanged, but the nurse notes a sudden increase in the patient's heart rate. You are asked to come and evaluate the patient. Upon evaluation of the patient, you note that the heart rate is 145 a minute, the blood pressure is 115 over 65, the respiratory rate is 18, the SpO2 is 97% on room air, the temperature, the patient's afebrile, and the patient is 75 years old. What are going to be your initial actions? Well, we're going to begin with our ACLS assessment. So we want to assess the appropriateness for clinical condition. The heart rate typically is going to be greater than or equal to 150 per minute if it is considered an tachy arrhythmia. So we need to look and identify the underlying cause as well as treat it. So we want to make sure that we're maintaining a patent airway and assist with breathing as necessary. The patient in this particular scenario is breathing on their own very effectively. We want to make sure that we're providing oxygenation if the patient is hypoxemic. As we know, based on the vital signs, their SpO2 is equal to 97% and their on-room air. So this intervention is not necessary. We also want to make sure that we look at the cardiac monitor to identify the rhythm, as well as monitor blood pressure and oximetry. We look at the monitor, we know that this is a narrow complex QRS tachycardia. When looking at our blood pressure, we have a mean arterial pressure of 82, which is greater than 65, so we know that there is no signs of any kind of perfusion issues taking place. We want to make sure that the patient has IV access. In this particular case, most likely after most surgeries, after all surgeries, they're going to have a patent IV. And of course, we want to make sure that we do that 12-lead ECG if it is available. We obviously do not want to delay therapy if it is unnecessary. So once we start doing those interventions, we need to see if this is a persistent tachyarrhythmia causing other symptoms. So one, is the patient hypotensive? As we know, the patient's blood pressure was fine, so there's no hypotension present. Does the patient have any acutely altered mental status? Well, when you ask the patient your questions, they're going to be alert and oriented times four. So we know that that is not taking place. Is there any signs of shock? Well, the patient does have a rapid pulse, but there's no other symptoms, so it doesn't seem like the patient is in shock at this time. Is there any ischemic chest discomfort present? When you ask the patient is going to deny. And then lastly, is there any acute heart failure? Not likely. The patient doesn't have any history of acute heart failure, and they're not exhibiting any signs of it. So based on this, we can effectively say that none of these things are taking place. So the next intervention that we're going to look at is there a QRS that's wide, greater than or equal to 0.12? So as we go back and take a look at the rhythm that we had, we can see that this narrow tachycardia does not have a wide QRS. So based on our algorithm, what we're going to start looking at when it comes to interventions is potentially vagal maneuvers if the rhythm is regular in the situation. It is regular, so that could potentially be an option. Adenosine, as well, if it's regular, is absolutely an option. That's where we stop the heart and it restarts and hopefully it reprograms itself back to the right rhythm. We can look at giving beta blockers or calcium channel blockers depending on what's going on with the heart rate and the blood pressure. And of course, we always want to consider some kind of expert consultation when it comes to these patients. So after doing those interventions, if the rhythm is refractory, meaning that it comes back, then we may consider trying to figure out what the underlying cause is. We may even want to look at cardioversion for these patients, as well as additional antiarrhythmic medications. And of course, we always want to make sure that we're talking to our experts when it comes to treatment for these patients. If we need to start any kind of antiarrhythmic infusions for stable wide QRS tachycardias, we have options for those. But really, when we're looking at this patient scenario, what is the underlying cause? So as we reassess our patient, you're going to notice that the patient's heart rate is now back to 84 per minute. Her bedside ECG now states that she is in a normal sinus rhythm, and she still remains asymptomatic. well, what was the underlying cause? Really, we're not going to be sure in these scenarios. You are going to have scenarios where these patients go into these weird rhythms and then just go right back to being a normal sinus rhythm. These patients need to be continued with expert consultation as well as monitoring, and they absolutely should follow up with a cardiologist for further testing to see what happened and if there was some kind of underlying cause that we didn't know. So with these scenarios, absolutely, post-surgical patients, you're going to see these weird rhythms. You will see this particular scenario when you're taking your ACLS Megacode. So hopefully this will help you pass when it comes to those stable tachycardias. I hope that this video was helpful in understanding what to do in this ACLS Megacode scenario. If you have any additional questions, make sure that you leave them down below. I love answering your questions. Make sure you follow me on my social media. I'm on Facebook as well as Instagram. If you're not already, subscribe here on YouTube and make sure you turn on that bell notification so you're notified every time I post a new video. If you haven't done so already, make sure that you check out my website at www.nursechung.com, where there's additional resources on the ACLS algorithms as well as scenarios. But until next time, I hope that you're having a wonderful day, and I will see you all again soon. Bye.